I want to explain for our viewers that maybe don't know so much about Frontext that it's basically you're remodeling yourself to a new way of doing stuff, more focused on long-term deployment of your of Frontext agents in member states. Could you develop on that program a little bit?
Sure. You may remember that the project of the European Standing Corps was decided in 2019 by the EU legislator, and we have the objective to build this Standing Corps by 2027. We are expected to have up to 10,000 border guard and coast guard under this European Standing Corps. Right now, we are recruiting the first wave of Frontex employees, so EU border guards, that will be deployed for the first time with a European uniform on behalf of the European Union. So previously, we had in our operations only national border guards and coast guard officers deployed under the umbrella of Frontex operations. But now with the European Standing Corps, we are recruiting right now a total of up to 600 or even more border guards that will be deployed in 2021. And these are the so-called Category 1, which means that they will be EU employees, EU staff. There are other categories of border guards in the Standing Corps that will come from the national authorities, so from member states, but they will be seconded up to 4 years to Frontex, which means that the backbone of this European Standing Corps will be composed at the, let's say, when we will reach the cruise speed, we will have approximately 3,000 EU employees working as border guards in European uniform, plus up to 7,000 national border guards embedded in the European Standing Corps, and some of them, let's say 3,000, 4,000, seconded to Frontex for a period up to 4 years. So that's where we are. We have the first batch of 265 successful candidates that started the training this week on the 16th of June. Of course, there are many candidates from Romania.
That was going to be my next question. How many are from Romania?
Well, in total, we have 56 Romanian successful candidates in this first batch of 265. So we have, let's say, one-fifth of the new recruits right now are from Romania. The profile of the new recruits, the majority of them come from the law enforcement sector, from border police, coast guard, and in general, they had previously an employment with a uniformed service.
Okay, so this is a program that's ongoing, so we'll be recruiting in the future more and more. And these, like you said, level one European employees that will be in the in Frontex, will they be deployed as well in countries to work side by side with national authorities, national forces?
That's exactly the project. They will be deployed in, potentially they can be deployed in each member state of the European Union or Schengen associated countries. They can also be deployed in third countries. We have already now an operation in Albania, and there are ongoing plans to deploy Frontex operations in other Western Balkan countries. Of course, they will be deployed side by side with the national authorities, the national authorities of the host member state, and of course, the national authorities made available by the member states. So, for example, right now in Greece, I was saying that we have 600 border guards or coast guard officers deployed there. So if we had already the European Standing Corps, we would certainly have one third of them being Frontex employees, EU employees, and the rest national border guards coming from all member states.